Silk Sound Bite Films.
Sophomore, I was probably in eighth grade. He was always 2 years older than me, so I think that's about right. We needed to go to the park and hoop, or we was getting dressed, or we was going up to the mall. You know what I'm saying? Evergreen Plaza was the spot at the time. But this particular day, I came over, and he was already on the phone chopping it up with this chick, right? And it was going back and forth, man. Like, they was arguing and shit, but they really wasn't. You know, they was just bullshit in a playful way, you dig? So the next thing I heard was, shit, you got me fucked up, I'm on my way. So he hung up the phone and shit, and he was like, shit, come on, let's go. So I'm like, shit, let's ride. At the time, I don't know who this chick is, I don't know where she live at, or none of that shit. But when cuz say, let's ride, we riding, as usual. So on our way out the door, he grabs up the heat. And in my head, I'm thinking like, well, shit, we just going to see this chick, right? Then I thought about it. If you know anything about being around Silk, you gotta be prepared for anything. Cause he was about that life. So I ain't thinking nothing of it. You know, it's business as usual. He taking it for precautionary reasons. So we jump in the MC, Monte Carlo. For those who don't know what that is, silver joint. That motherfucker was clean as fuck. White leather seats and a white top. So we riding, we chopping it up back and forth, politicking and shit still, as usual. Nothing out of the ordinary. Until I realize, man, I look around and like, dog, we in an op neighborhood. Instantly, I'm like, cuz, where the fuck we going? So right off top, he started laughing and shit, cause he know that I know we ain't supposed to be over there. So he say, man, fuck these pussy ass niggas, man. These pussy ass motherfuckers ain't gonna do shit on BD. So I'm like, oh damn. His whole demeanor changed. So what's up there? You know what I'm saying? So instantly I'm on point. We pull up to the spot. We had to park across the street because right directly in front of our house was a car. So we couldn't park right there. So we parked right directly across the street from my house. You know what I'm saying? So I could see both corners. So on both corners you could see these niggas just chopping it up. You know what I mean? So I'm thinking maybe it might be a trap or some shit, you know what I'm saying? But I see that it's not that because they ain't even paying attention at first, you know what I'm saying? So I'm thinking he gonna go inside the house and holler at her. But right when I was done with that thought, the girl ended up coming outside the house, down the stairs, and sitting on the cement embankment in front of the house.
Like I was saying, yeah, she came down the stairs and sat on the cement embankment, right on the sidewalk in front of her house. If you know anything about the type of women that Silk deal with, they're not only pretty, but they're dangerous. You know what I'm saying? He loved women that challenged him. Feel me? So I took this right here as a challenge, what she was doing right here. Because she knew the situation. You feel me? So I glance up and down the block at these niggas again. I look at him. He looking at her laughing like she knows she on some bullshit. So he hand me the heat. I'm sitting in the car. He walks across the street. They chopping it up in front of the house. Now right when he got out the car and walked across the street, these niggas noticed it. They looked dead at him. He seen that shit. He didn't give no fuck. So I give it about 5 minutes, maybe 10. I checked the ends of the block again. Now it's a couple of members that's been added to the party on each end of the street. And they both looking down at the middle of the street where we are, looking dead as silk. I put my hand on my heat, but I'm sweating bullets, cause it's just me and this motherfucking gun. And I'm not finna let shit happen to cuz on my watch. Meanwhile, he just chopping it up like he at home and shit, like he ain't worried about nothing else that's going on around him. And that's just the way he was. Best believe, you know, he know what's going on and he can see everything that's going on. But like he said, fuck these pussy ass niggas, man. These niggas ain't gonna do shit on BD, which they didn't. We sat there a whole 2 hours and the motherfuckers didn't make a move towards the middle of that block. By this time, you know, he done pulled her in. You can see it in her eyes. She's like, I can't believe this crazy ass nigga. So after a little while, they got done with their conversation and shit. He come back, jump in the car. We ride out. Right past this niggas. Mugging the shit out these motherfuckers. Did not make a move. You understand me? And that's when ultimately I knew that cuz was crazy than the motherfucker. But not only that, he had the gift of just reading people. Reading things around him quick. He knew how far he can push that line. Thanks for listening. I got more to come, so stay tuned.
I'll be quick to run up, let it